There is a very positive correlation between the GDP of the countries and the exim merchandise trade. If you see over the years, this ratio has been increasing, and in 2017, the exim merchandise trade is approximately 44% of the GDP. In India, we are in the range of about 30%, and 95% of the exim trade being dependent on the ports. So the ports are becoming more and more important in the economies of the countries. And the studies indicate that the growth of the cities which are near to the ports have been in the range of 12 to 13%, as compared to the average growth of 8 to 9% growth in the cities across the world, other than the port cities. Second take from this thing is that in India, incidentally, we are having high logistic costs in the range of 14 to 15% of our GDP, compared to 8 to 9% of the logistic costs in other countries. So in India, we have a huge potential for exploiting our coastal line to the advantage of reducing our logistic costs for our economic development. Now, to reduce the logistic cost, the transport by water plays an important role, because as Admiral Dhawan was mentioning in the forenoon, the water transport, apart from being cheaper, is also environmental friendly and very cheap mode, very clean mode of transport. If we look at the data for the intermodal mix of the water transport in the various countries, we find that India has only about 6% of our movement is through the transport, through the water transport. And even the countries which are, even the countries like Bangladesh, they have 15% of the movement through the water transport. China has in the range of about 24% through the water transport. Japan is about 35% movement through the water transport. So this is one area which is the focus area of the Sagarmala program, to how to enhance the movement through the water transport. The program aims to enhance the movement of the intermodal share of the water transport from 6% to 12% by the year 2025. As of now, we are having about 107 million tons of the cargo movement through coastal shipping, and about 55 million tons of cargo movement through our inland waterways. The target is that by the year 2022, the movement of the cargo through inland waterways is targeted to be around 150 million ton, and the coastal movement through the coastal shipping, the target is to enhance it to about 220 million ton by the year 2025. This translates to a growth of about 10% for the coastal shipping and about 15% for the transportation through the inland waterways. Traditionally, we have not been able to have the coastal shipping movement, because traditionally our industries have been in the hinterland area. 30 districts, which represent about 73% of the India's GDP, and out of these 30 districts, 70% of the districts are located beyond 200 kilometers of the coastal line. A study indicates that our average lead from the port to the hinterland is in the range of about 700 to 1,000 kilometers average lead. Whereas in many of the maritime states, this lead is in the range of 150 to 300 kilometers. Now, this enhanced lead adds to the logistic costs for the transportation of cargo from the coastal areas to the hinterland. So now, as a part of this program, the aim is to reduce this distance to in the range of about 150 to 200 kilometers, so that our logistic costs reduce. And one of the ingredients of the program is to have the industrial centers near to the coastline. So now, to address the various constraints which I mentioned, that is our high logistic cost, our less share of inland transport, certain areas were identified when this program, Sagarmala program, was launched, that which are the problem areas and how to tackle these problem areas. I have listed down some of the areas, that is port infrastructure and productivity is one of the areas wherein the inadequate capacity of the ports as well as productivity of the ports, lack of technological penetration at the Indian ports, complicated procedures and documentations increasing the cost and time of the cargo movement. Then last mile connectivity to the ports is an important area, which includes the connectivity through rail, road, pipelines. Then we have conveyor belts for easy evacuation from the ports. Then, as I mentioned, the enhancing the intermodal mix of the waterways, industrialization near the ports, because we have been having a very limited development of exim-oriented manufacturing facilities near the ports. Then enhancing the employment opportunities for the coastal community, skill development required for the port sector, increasing the awareness about the safety practices, and reducing the pollution in the marine sector. So the program, as Admiral Dhawan was mentioning in the forenoon session, is rests on, there are four basic pillars for this port-led development. One is the port modernization, which caters to capacity augmentation, development of new ports, efficiency improvement of the ports. Then the second pillar is about the port connectivity, which is new roads, rail connectivity, upgradation of road and railway infrastructure in the ports, development of coastal shipping, inland water transport, and the logistic development of the logistic parks. Third pillar is the port-led industrialization, that is development of the industrial clusters near to the coastal areas, coastal economic zones, and maritime clusters. And the fourth pillar, which in terms of value may not be much, but it is very important for the coastal communities, that is skill development in the coastal areas, coastal tourism, and development of fishing harbors and fish processing centers. The program estimates that it will reduce the savings in the logistic cost to the extent of about 35,000 to 40,000 crores per annum by the year 2025. So as I mentioned, if you talk in terms of the investments which have been envisaged so far out of the projects identified under the various pillars, port modernization has the investments in the range of about 1.5 lakh crores, port connectivity 2.5 lakh crores, coastal community development is 7,000 crore, and port industrialization is 4.7 lakh crores. The total program as of now has identified about 605 projects, costing about 8.7 lakh crores. Now there are about 60 implementing agencies which I have mentioned here, like major ports, maritime boards, Ministry of Shipping, Ministry of Road Transport, NHAI, Ministry of Railways, Inland Waterway Authority of India, Indian Port Rail Corporation Limited, CONCOR, state governments, then Ministry of Rural Development, state government fisheries departments, tourism departments, and various line ministries are involved in these execution of these various projects. Coming to the capacity of the ports, since the beginning of the program, the capacity of the major ports has increased by approximately 77%. Is expected to increase by 77%. Presently, it has increased approximately by 50%. That is, at the beginning of the program in 2015, it was 965 million ton. The major ports are since then increased by about 500 million ton. And minor ports as of now has capacity of about 850 million ton. And by the year 2025, so roughly we have a capacity of, present capacity of the ports is in the range of 2300 million ton. And by the year 2025, the capacity is likely to be about 3500 million ton. And 3500 million ton, when I say, it means the port should be, with that capacity, port should be able to handle about 2500 million tons of cargo. Presently, all our ports, including major and minor, they are handling in the range of about 1200 million tons. So it is almost doubling the capacity of the ports by the year 2025. There has been a reduction in the basic parameters for measuring the efficiency of the ports are the turnaround time and the dwell time of the at the port and the ship berth day output. So as we see in the slide, there has been consistent increase in the ship berth day output and decline in the dwell time at the ports. JNPT has now the container dwell time in the range of around 40 hours, and for the current financial year, the target is to reduce it to 36 hours and for the containers. And the overall dwell time at the major ports is in the range of 64 hours, which for the current year is targeted to be around 60 hours. Now, it is heartening to note that because of these initiatives, the one of the parameters which World Bank monitors is the ranking of the India in trade across borders. And in the year 2018, the ranking has increased from 146 to 80. So this is a substantial jump in the ranking because of the various measures taken by the ports and the various ease of doing initiatives taken by the ports as well as the government. So these are some of the initiatives which have been taken for ease of doing business, that is direct port delivery, direct port entry, installment of the container scanners, gate automation systems, RFID, some IT initiatives, and elimination of all the types of manual forms. On digitization and automation, IT-enabled data collection and billing is now operational at all the major ports. DMIC has installed the scanners on all the containers to track the movement of containers and accordingly to take measures how to reduce the detention at various places. PC1X system, which was catering now so far to the 19 stakeholders, has now recently, only last month, has been installed to cater to 8 more types of stakeholders, and it is a cloud-based platform which is more user-friendly compared to the earlier version, that is PC1. Then RFID control, access control at ports has been implemented, ERP systems have been implemented. For the participation of the private sector, last year the government has changed the based on the interaction with the stakeholders, the government has relaxed the norms for participation of the private sector. And some of the important measures which have been undertaken are that now the concessionaires can exit by divesting up to 100% of the ownership after 2 years of commissioning. Then they can pay the royalty on the per TU basis rather than the revenue sharing basis. Earlier the land was not available, additional port land was not available, was available at twice the bid out rate, now it is available at 1.2 times the rate. Then there is a freedom to upgrade the capacity of the equipments which was not available in the earlier concession agreements. And if there is any change in the laws of the government, then there is a compensation mechanism for paying the compensation to the private sector. And a separate body is being instituted to handle the arbitration and dispute cases for the faster clear, dispute settlement. As of now, we have about 16 ongoing projects, PPP projects, entailing an investment of about 20,000 crores. and it will generate a capacity of about 268 million ton additional capacity through PPP. When we talk of the connectivity to the ports, what has been identified is that poor connectivity of road and rail infrastructure, then existing road and rail networks are quite congested, and lack of availability of sufficient rake at the ports for evacuation from the ports. So under the program, about 8,700 kilometers of road and about 4,200 kilometers of railway line have been identified to be developed near the ports. And national waterways, as I mentioned earlier, are also being developed for the connectivity to the ports. About 200 kilometers of rail network and another about 200 kilometers of road network is likely to be added by the year 2020, which relates to purely to the connectivity to the ports. Now coming to the coastal shipping, which I mentioned that in order to enhance the intermodal mix of the water transport in the overall transport sector, cabotage has been relaxed for movement of the exim oblique empty containers, and for agricultural commodities, animal husbandry produce and farm sector and fertilizers. This was relaxed sometime in May last year. 16 additional coastal berths purely for the coastal purposes have been are under implementation. Two have already been commissioned. And there is a reduction in the port and vessel related charges for the to promote the coastal movement. There is a provision for a priority berthing for the coastal vessels. And ADB has undertaken a study to with the in consultation to have consultations with the stakeholders how to further enhance the coastal shipping, what are the problem areas and how to tackle those problem areas. This study is likely to be completed next month. Then another important thing for the evacuation from the ports is the development of multimodal logistic parks. 15 multimodal logistic parks are already planned under Sagarmala, out of which 3 have been completed. And Concor has undertaken 7. Major ports have undertaken 6 of the multimodal logistic parks. Ministry of Road Transport is having one at Jogigopa, and one is by the state government at Darjeeling. The average growth of the coastal shipping in the recent, in fact last year it was in the range of about 15%, but average growth if we see from 2013-14 onward, it is in the range of about 8% as compared to the port sector growth of about 5%. And it is targeted that in the coming years, this coastal shipping should be growing in the range of 14-15% per annum. Regarding port-led industrialization, which I mentioned, there are about 14 coastal employment zones have been identified under the Sagarmala program for development. The development of these coastal, the policy formulation is under finalization for the development of these 14 coastal economic zones. In addition to that, we have about 4 lakh crore worth of investment for the industrial clusters. About 36 industrial clusters have been identified near to the coastline. Then the ports, major ports have the additional land which is now being used for the industrial purposes. And 2 smart industrial port cities are planned, one at Dindyal port and another at Paradip port. JNPT has come out with a SEZ which is expected to have an investment of about 12,000 crores. The bidding process has already started. About 75 acres of land has been bid out, and another 300 acres of land is likely to be bid out very shortly. Then Kamrajar and Chidambarnar ports are coming up with coastal employment units, development of coastal employment units at their ports. And then there are 2 maritime clusters which are planned, one is in Gujarat and another is in Tamil Nadu. For addressing the problem of the skill development, a study for 21 coastal districts have been undertaken, and the areas for the trainings have been identified. First phase of the program is already complete, and in phase two, that is from the year 2018-19, there is a target of training about 10,000 persons annually for the next 3 years. Under the skill development program, Center of Excellence for Ship Build and Maritime Building has been set up. It has 24 laboratories, 16 at Vizag and 18 at Vizag and 6 at Mumbai. And this is first of its kind center which has come up. It has recently come up, and it is going to impart skills for related to ship hull design, ship detail design, ship building, maintenance, repairs, overall, etc. And the target is that not only India, but it is likely to attract the students from the neighboring countries for the at this center. JNPT is coming up with a multi-skill development center. This is likely to be commissioned very soon. And 8 major ports are also coming up with the development of the multi-skill development centers. Ministry has also set up a national technology center for ports, waterways and coasts at IIT Chennai. This is for indigenization of the technologies related to the port sector. And the ports have already started realizing the benefits of this center, and many of the projects undertaken by this center, the experience is that there has been huge cost saving, and so far the reliance was on the consultants which were expats, but this center is coming in a big way, and a decision has also been taken, in fact it has already been commissioned, to set up another center at IIT Kharagpur. So IIT Kharagpur center would be focusing on the ship building, especially the shallow, the ships related to the shallow draft, primarily related to the inland waterways. So the testing and the design and these capabilities are being developed at IIT Kharagpur by setting another center. So certain initiatives have also been taken under this program that relates to the environmental management and monitoring plan, prohibition of disposal in sea, plantation to increase the green cover at the ports. 18 megawatt of solar power and 6 megawatt of wind power have already been commissioned at the major ports, and there are additional about 31 megawatt capacity works under implementation. And for the development of facilities and deployment of trained resources for oil spill resources, Ministry has provided financial assistance of about 20 crores. Now, coming to the various list of the various projects which have been undertaken this program, under the Sagarmala program. Out of the 605 projects which I mentioned, 502 projects are planned to be awarded by the year 2020. To clarify, this is a 20-year program starting from the year 2015. So 502 projects are planned to be awarded by year 2020, and 65% of the projects by value have already been awarded so far. The projects awarded so far entail an investment of about 2.65 lakh crores. And regarding the completion of the projects, about 100 projects have already been completed, and it is targeted that by the year 2020, 262 projects will be completed. So this is briefly the Sagarmala program so far.